Welcome to a lesson on approximating square roots using division. This process will allow you to approximate a square root without the use of a calculator. Let's begin by approximating the square root of 23. Since we know the square root of 16 equals 4, since 4 squared equals 16, and the square root of 25 equals 5, since 5 squared equals 25, it is reasonable to guess the square root of 23 is approximately 5, since 23 is closer to 25 than it is to 16. Let's let the first approximation of the square root of 23 be equal to 5. The next step is to divide 23, the radicand, by the first approximation of 5. Notice 23 divided by 5 equals 4.6. The next step is to make a new approximation between the quotient of 4.6 and the original approximation of 5, and then we divide this into 23 again. Let's guess 4.8, because 4.8 is between 4.6 and 5. Notice 23 divided by 4.8 is approximately 4.79, and 4.79 is very close to our approximation of 4.8. So we could repeat this process by now making a new approximation between 4.79 and 4.8, but notice how the square root of 23 is approximately 4.79, since the square of 4.79 is equal to 22.9441, which is very close to 23. So as we go through this process, as the quotient becomes closer and closer to our approximation, we have more and more accuracy. Let's look at a second example. Let's now approximate the square root of 68. Since we know the square root of 64 equals 8 and the square root of 81 equals 9, it is reasonable to guess the square root of 68 is approximately 8, since 68 is closer to 64 than it is to 81. Let's let the first approximation for the square root of 68 be 8. Step 2, we divide the radicand of 68 by 8. 68 divided by 8 equals 8.5. Step 3, we now make a new approximation between the quotient of 8.5 and the original guess of 8, and then we divide this into 68. Let's guess 8.25, because 8.25 is between 8.5 and 8. And now we divide 68 by 8.25, which gives us approximately 8.24. Again, notice how 8.24 is very close to our approximation of 8.25, and therefore 8.24 is a good approximation for the square root of 68. Again, we could repeat this process by making a new approximation between 8.24 and 8.25, but the square root of 68 is approximately 8.24, since the square of 8.24 equals 67.89, which again is very close to 68. So now let's take a look at why this process works. In example 1, we were approximating the square root of 23. So if we let n equal the exact value of the square root of 23, and then we square both sides of the equation, we get the equation n squared equals 23, where n is greater than or equal to 0. From here, if we divide both sides of the equation by n and simplify, we end up with n equals 23 divided by n. So if we knew the exact value of the square root of 23, the exact value would also be equal to this quotient, which means the real value of the square root of 23 must be somewhere between an approximate value of the square root of 23 and 23 divided by the approximate value. Similarly, for the square root of 68, the real value of the square root of 68 must be somewhere between an approximate value of the square root of 68 and 68 divided by the approximate value. This is the reason why this division algorithm works to approximate square roots. I hope you found this helpful.